Hi, my name is James Harris. I'm a general surgeon working for Johns Hopkins at Howard County General Hospital. A hiatal hernia is a type of hernia where you have a hole in the diaphragm, which is a little bit too large and allows part of the stomach to actually go into the chest. In normal situations, you only have a hole that's big enough for the esophagus to go through, and then that's where the stomach starts. But with people that have a significant size hiatal hernia, the hole around the esophagus is too large, and that allows part of the stomach to go into the chest. For some of these hernias that are very large, a good part, if not even the whole stomach, could be in the chest, and that could cause significant symptoms. Hiatal hernias can happen to people of many ages. It tends to happen to people over the age of 30. It tends to be larger in the older population. A lot of people tend to live with these hernias for a long period of time, not realizing that they have it. And by the time the symptoms get so bad, it's often as they're in their 50s or 60s, and we tend to see them to be quite large at that time. Most significant symptoms that people have is reflux, problems with swallowing food, discomfort in their chest, especially after eating. Many folks tend to find that if they try to have a late meal and lay down quickly after eating, they feel the food coming back up into their mouth. And a lot of these folks even find that if they have certain foods that are spicy or tend to be acidic, they tend to cause a lot more of their reflux symptoms. So my workup for a hiatal hernia is endoscopy. We go down and take a look at the hernia from the inside, and we want to make sure that the esophagus is healthy, make sure there's no masses or ulcers or anything like that, and we inspect the stomach. Often from looking at the hiatal hernia from the inside, you could see part of the stomach protruding into the chest from the inside. It's often hard to really get a good estimate of the size of the hernia that way because you're looking at it from the inside, so we always get a CT scan to show how much of the surrounding, you know, stomach is actually going into the chest. Are there other organs possibly going into the chest? And then finally we get an upper GI study where we have them drink contrast, and that helps not only show how much of the stomach is in the chest, but also helps give us a little bit of an idea about the function of the esophagus to make sure that it's emptying normally. If we see any kind of abnormality with the upper GI study, sometimes there are other tests that we do to be able to work up the hiatal hernia further. If someone has a type of hiatal hernia that includes part of the stomach going into the chest, that type of hiatal hernia should be evaluated for repair. The most common type of hiatal hernia is what's called a sliding hiatal hernia, and it does not have really much of the stomach going into the chest. It tends to have part of the stomach sliding in and out, but it's a very small component. And most of these people have pretty good management with just medication. If they have what's called a type 3 paraesophageal hernia, those are the type of hernias that I tend to fix operatively. And that means that part of the stomach is living in their chest most of the time, if not all the time. And those type of hernias tend to cause the most symptoms.